Hey, what's up? It's Tom. Today we're going to use ON1 Photo RAW and look at four ways to retouch eyebags. Afterwards, we'll look at all of them and you can decide which method you like best. So here's a shot of Aiyana, and I'm going to hit the letter D to bring it into develop. And as always, when shooting a raw image, the first thing I always do is choose a camera profile. And for this image, let's go with camera portrait. So I was shooting the Canon R5. If we take a look at this, it was ISO 100, so a very clean image. 1/200th of a shutter speed. This was with flash. And shooting at f5.6. So just a very simple shot with butterfly lighting. One lighting coming from above, a reflector underneath, and then a second light that's lighting a little bit of the background. It was a strip box above her. It's also giving a little separation on the shoulders and hair. So very easy lighting setup, but gives great results. So let's take a look at the four different methods. So first thing I'm going to do is come up to the upper right corner, select snapshots, and let's do a snapshot now. All we've done so far is the camera profile. So that's what we'll call this. You'll notice I didn't have to adjust exposure, contrast, or any of that because the exposure is really good. So the first method for eye bags, let's do the easiest one, and that's going to just go to portrait and let ON1 do the work. I'm going to turn off the skin softening. I have a video on how I like to selectively be able to correct skin blemishes. I'll put a link below in case you'd like to watch that video. On the eyes, just for this tutorial, I'm going to turn off the whitening, the detail, and the brow enhance because we're going to just concentrate on the dark circles. So let's zoom into the image. A couple ways we can do that. If we hold down the Option and Alt key, if you have a mouse with a scroll wheel, you can zoom in that way. And then you can let go of the Option and Alt key, still use the scroll wheel to go up and down on the image. So that's a real easy way to do it. With the portrait module selected, we're going to use the dark circles and adjust the intensity of that. Around 90 is looking great. And we'll do a snapshot of that. So let's just call this portrait. And then we're going to reset this. And turn it off. And let's go with the second method. And that's using the retouch tool. And that's the letter R. You can click on the Band-Aid and select it. We want a real low opacity. And then we're just going to paint over some of these dark areas. And it's going to help reduce it, because it's kind of blending from the bright to the dark. I used to use this method a lot just because it is super quick and it gives really nice results. But you do want to make sure that you have a very low opacity when using this. And then you can use the bracket keys to make your brush larger or smaller. Let's do a snapshot of that. And that is the retouch brush. Next, I'm going to go up to settings. And we'll reset the portrait. We'll reset the retouching. Make sure those have no effect. Now we'll go to the third method. And that is using the clone stamp tool, which is Shift S. And you'll see that down here. And up here as well, we are using the clone stamp. and also very low opacity. First thing with the clone stamp, though, is you have to pick a reference point. So we'll hold down the Alt or Option key, click on that, and that is where we're sampling from. And then we'll go ahead and paint on, click and drag. You can keep resampling as you move around. So Option Alt, sample, then click and drag. Okay, and that's looking a little strong. I'm going to hit Command Z, kind of back out of here. That's better. And let me start that one more time. Going to lower the opacity even a little bit more, 5%. And that's looking pretty good. So we'll do a snapshot of that. And that is our clone stamp. And once again, we'll go up to settings and reset all retouching. And we're now back at our beginning point. All right, so if I click on camera profile, there's not going to be any change. Finally, let's go into a method that I used to use all the time in Photoshop. It is a great method for retouching darker bags. So to convert the Photoshop method into ON1, I do have to make a few tweaks, but the best way to do it would be using local, add adjustment, and we want to select paint with color. Then I'm going to find a fairly bright area on the skin that doesn't have an off color, like not a red area. So that's looking pretty good there. And with this, we want to paint. We're using the brush tool, which is the letter B, masking brush. Low opacity, we want to make sure it's on paint, and we don't want to use the perfect brush. So make sure that is off by clicking on it. Okay, I'm going to increase the size of the brush. It uses the same bracket keys. In Photoshop, there is an opacity and flow. When I did it in Photoshop, flow is a preferred method. You have a lot more control. So I would do the opacity at 100 and the flow rate at 10. With ON1, we don't have flow, so I'm just doing a low opacity. So that's looking pretty good. All right, so let's do a snapshot of that, and we'll just call that paint. All right, so I did do a lot more of that, but I did that for a purpose, so you can see a major advantage of this method. So last thing we need to do on here is go up to blending. We want to select the blend mode to lighten. And now with the opacity, we can play around. And so we see that, and we can kind of fine tune it to our liking. All right, so I'm doing it about halfway. And let's make a snapshot of this. We'll call this paint. All right, so this is where the fun begins. I'm going to just back out of this just a little bit. We're in pretty close, and let's look at the four different methods. First thing though, I am going to save this because this is going to let us see some of the benefits afterwards. All four of these are non-destructive, but not all of them are re-editable. So with Retouch and the clone stamp, we are baking those in we can't lower the opacity on those or make it stronger unless we redo the clone stamp and the retouch. Going to hit OK, and then just now that we're back in the browser, I'm going to hit the letter D, take us back in, and let's compare the different methods. So you can decide for yourself which one you like best. So here is the portrait method. It does a really nice job. It applies it the same amount throughout. So where this part's darker, this part's lighter, it wasn't able to really even it out as much. It also keeps some of the red coloring underneath the eyes. But the advantage of this is you can always go back to portrait, scroll down, and still edit that dark circle effect. Let's go to retouch, and that one's still pretty good. It's still a little bit darker. If we continue to use the retouch brush, we're just going to start losing more skin texture. And the downside is we can't lessen the effect. The only way we can lessen the effect is by going up and resetting all retouching tools. So if we did any cloning on her jacket to get rid of stray hairs or things like that, we would be resetting everything that we did to this image. So that is the retouch. Next is the clone stamp. And that works pretty nice as well. This is one of my go-to methods. The downside, though, is the same as the retouch brush. We can't lower the opacity of what we did with it. We can only grab the tool and do more of it. And then finally, the paint method. And to me, that one looks really nice. And the advantage of this one is just like with the portrait mode, we can always go back into blending. We can change the opacity if we want it less, or if we wanted it even stronger than what we did. We also can go into the mask and we can feather the mask. Sometimes that can also make a helpful change. So not only is it non-destructive, it is re-editable. So those are the four ways to retouch those eye bags. Let me know in the comments which method you prefer. Using the portrait, the retouch, the clone stamp, or painting with the color. Changing the blend mode to lighten, and then using the opacity to make it either stronger or weaker. If you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to the channel and click on the bell so you're notified of my next video. Until next time, keep shooting.